Hey, welcome home. You're watching Legacy Television. We're Jeremy and Sarah Pearsons. You know, every time we start one of these broadcasts, we always start it with welcome home. That's because family is a big deal to me and to Sarah. And not just our family. Of course, we love our little ones. We've got little Justice. He's 6 years old. Jessie Grace, she's three. And we love the family the Lord's given us. But Sarah and I also live with this other realization that we're part of the household of faith. That's the household we were born into. That's the household that gave life to us. And it's going to give life to you too. And we always want you to know you're welcome in the house of faith. There's a place for you at the table in the house of faith. So that's why we always say, welcome home. That and the fact that we, you know, this was our house. And so you're always welcome in it. And you're always welcome at the throne of God, at the throne of grace. And don't ever let condemnation keep you away from there. Don't ever let guilt or feelings of unworthiness keep you out of the presence of God. No, he said, come boldly to the throne of grace. So that's exactly what we're going to do today. As we get into the word, we're going to come boldly. We're going to get from God what he wants us to have, what we need from him. And his grace is going to be perfected in us. And his strength will be made perfect in weakness. This is going to be a good day on this broadcast. You chose a good day to tune in. Come on, let's pray together, and then Sarah will get right into the word. Father, you're so good to us. We love you, and we thank you for loving us. We come boldly before your word, boldly before the throne of grace. And Father, we lay hold by faith of everything that we need. Everything we need in our lives, everything we need in this ministry, everything those that are watching that they need in their families, their businesses, their home. Together we lay hold of it, knowing that you want us to have it. It's your will to give it to us, and you have the ability to enrich our lives in every area. Give us eyes today that see Jesus in the word, ears that hear his voice, hearts that understand who we are in him. We thank you for it and give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Sarah, let's get right back to where we began yesterday in the book of Colossians chapter 1. And I want to read again a few verses here. Paul writing to the folks in this church, in this city. If you missed any of the broadcasts from last week, you've got to go get it. I'm so excited about what the Lord's doing in these couple of weeks right here. Go back and get it. It's on our website, pearsonsministries.com. It's on our app, the Legacy Studios app. It's on YouTube. It's everywhere we can put it, basically. We want you to get it. So get caught up with this. But in these verses, Paul is writing to these people, and he's writing this letter talking about this relationship that they have with each other. And he said, we heard about you. Now, in this day and time, word didn't travel as fast as it does now. There was no instant messaging of any kind. Nothing was instant. Man, you wrote it down with a pen, but it wasn't even that.
A quill,
I guess it was. I don't have much experience with quill and papyrus or whatever they put that stuff on. But man, they would write it down and roll it up and send it across the water in a boat. Maybe it would take weeks, maybe it would take months, maybe it would never get there. But word got back to Paul, and he heard about the people in this city, in this church. He heard about two things, really three. First one was he heard about their faith in Jesus. And for Paul, that was enough to get him so excited, because this was a brand new, life-changing, world-changing message. Faith in Jesus. No longer are we subject to the bondage of the fear of death through the law. Now faith works. Mm. Now there's nothing between God and man but faith. And not only did he take it to those people who'd been living under that bondage, but he started taking it to the Gentiles and people who didn't know anything about God and any of this, and told them the story of what had happened for them through Jesus, and they grabbed a hold of it. He said, I heard about your faith in Jesus. I want that to be said about us. When people hear about us, I heard of Jeremy and Sarah. Man, those people of faith right there. Yeah, buddy, that's what I want people to say. But not just that, not just faith. He said, I heard about your faith in our Lord Jesus, and I heard about your love for all the saints. Those two things. If nobody ever heard anything else about me, I would be so happy and so satisfied. He's a man of faith and a man of love. If that's all they knew about us and our ministry, they're people of faith and they're people of love.
And you can't have one without the other.
You really can't.
You can't.
No, and that one's not effective.
Because you can have love. You can love and you can love and you love and have no revelation of how to live and walk by faith.
Yeah.
And it won't produce what it's supposed to produce. And then if you have so much faith, but you are without love.
Yeah, Paul said
faith
it's nothing.
Works by love. Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, Paul's writing to these people here and he goes on. He's talking about everything he's heard about them and what's happening in their lives. But he says in verse 7, he's talking about, you learned from Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who's a faithful minister in Christ on your behalf, who also declared to us your love in the Spirit. So what are the three things he heard? Faith in God, love for each other, and in particular, a love for him and his life and this ministry team that he was a part of. In verse 9, Paul said, for this reason, I heard how much you love God, you love each other, you love me. For this reason, we also, since the day we heard it, don't cease to pray for you and ask that you may be filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and in spiritual understanding. Now, this prayer goes on and it's powerful, and I encourage you to take some time to look at it. But the reason I bring this up is because I have written right here in my Bible out next to this verse, pray these words for your partners. Pray this for your partners. And that's why we spent so much time last week talking about what partnership means to us. It doesn't just all boil down to a check in the mail.
Mm-hmm.
And something's got to happen before there's ever a check, before there's ever a donation, before there's ever a contribution. All these words that you get into, I almost hesitate to say this, but a line of work like ours, these are some of those key words, donor base.
Mm-hmm.
Contribution. Who are your key contributors? And all these things. And people try to boil partnership down to how much money you're sending me. And what Sarah and I want you to know more than anything is that all that part of it, the finances, and of course, certainly it takes finances to operate this. Certainly we're believing God for big things. But when it comes to that, that's between you and God, not between us and you. What's between us and you, and as far as we're concerned, our part is this right here, praying for you, coming into agreement with you, preaching the word of God to you, preaching life to you, speaking light into darkness, life into death, healing into sickness. That's what our part in this thing mm-hmm. is. And that's why partnership is so significant to us, and we've been trained how to esteem this thing as so precious and so holy. And again, I remember sitting at that little kitchen table in that first little house we lived in when people first started partnering with us, when we started this ministry almost 7 years ago. And we didn't even know how people had found out about it, and yet they're sending an offering. It was a $10 seed here or a $50 seed there. And then one day it was a $1,000 seed. I mean, it was almost as though the amount had nothing to do with it.
Mm-hmm.
And we saw through to the heart of it.
Mm-hmm.
Really, that's a glimpse of how God sees it.
Yeah,
He's not looking at a mount near as much as natural men are. Mm-hmm. That's why He said here, I pray that you'd understand things spiritually, not just naturally. You start to understand spiritually and you look past the amount into mm-hmm. somebody's heart. And the heart of love is all over that offering. And it
yeah.
gets all over you and it brings you to your knees
mm-hmm.
in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
And we're so thankful for the people that the Lord has brought to us to partner with us. I mean, if you had an opportunity, and we do get this opportunity every now and then, but to look eye to eye, face to face, sit down like this. Let's say you were going to sit on a couch just like this with some partners of ours. I mean, what would you say to them? Well, look at them and tell them what you would say. I mean, how would you express our heart to them?
Well, I would say that
without crying.
Yeah,
that's going to be hard.
The tears are already flowing. Oh, this crying thing. It's like, we do this cry face. Like, when we start to cry, we're like,
just hold it back. Hold
it's
it
like,
back.
No, we're going to cry. No, I would just say that your offering and your honor for God has risen up before Him. And like the Bible says, it's like a sweet smell. And to us, it's like a sweet smell. I wouldn't say that when the money comes in that we don't look specifically at numbers and say, oh, that blesses me so much. But we do see through to the heart and we pray for you and we love you. It's so funny that you come up in our heart all the time.
Yeah.
Your children come up on our heart all the time. words for your children, the word of God for your children, the word of God for your family, the word of God for your finances, the word of God for you, for you to know the blessing of the Lord that's on your life. That's what comes up in our heart, the desire to give that to you. And so I think it's special to us to have a family. And we have a family with you. You are our family. Mm-hmm. And whether we know you personally or we don't, you are our family and you are in our hearts. Just as our family is here, our team at the ministry here, you are a part of our team. And you are helping us preach Jesus all over the world. We'll, someday in heaven, we'll get to talk about it if we never meet on earth. But yeah. I would just say, you mean so, so much to us. Yeah. And we, our lives are poured out as an offering for you. So
that's it. Yeah. Our lives are.
I did that without crying.
Well, kind of. But what did Paul say? He said, I would gladly spend and be spent. Mm-hmm. One of the greatest thrills I've ever experienced in this ministry is writing big checks for equipment, for airplane fuel, for salaries, for everything that it takes to operate this. That just, I have no problem letting it go. It excites me. I gladly spend. Why? Because every bit of that means words getting out, words getting out.
And I think about the legacy letter too.
Yeah.
Every time that we go our magazine. Yeah. Every time we go to write one of these legacy letters, Jeremy and I, we sit down and we seek the Lord for you. And we ask the Lord, Lord, what do you have in this season? Give us a word in season for our partners that would be a blessing to them. I don't know how many times we get testimonies from people that say, that word from that month is exactly what we needed right when we needed it.
Yeah.
And God gives us specific things for our people. And it's just awesome. I love it.
Yeah, it's a genuine thrill.
Yeah.
And it never gets old. I mean, on a consistent basis, our team, our office is sending us testimonies that we're getting from you and people around the world. And we print many of those here in the magazine. And it just never, ever gets old. I mean, you never get tired of hearing what Jesus is doing in somebody's life and how humbling it is when you realize he's using you.
Yeah.
He's using you. And I say, use us, Lord. Sarah, in just a minute, I want you to read actually from the magazine some things we printed towards the end of last year. 2016 was a big year for us, specifically because we launched the television ministry. This is something the Lord had dealt with us very specifically on months, even years leading up to that. And this was a major goal. And it's not a goal that you meet and you're done. It's like you get to this goal and now you can start. And that's what this television ministry has been about. So we've got some more goals set out in front of us, and we'll tell you about that more in a moment. But this past year was monumental, but I don't think it even begins to compare to what's coming in 2017. The vision is growing in us, and it's not as though we're adding new things. It's just what he's already told us to do is getting bigger every day. We want you to understand something. When Sarah and I talk to you about partnership and what that means to us, we see it in three parts of partnership, if you will. Number one, you've got God's part in it. And men make mistake in their endeavors when they start trying to do God's part. I can't do God's part of the partnership. You can't do God's part of the partnership. Only God can do his part. And what is his part? Grace is his part. So some of these things we've written and we published in one of the magazines. These are available if you weren't subscribing to them already. They're available through our app, the Legacy Studios app. You can get a hold of that. And I won't read the whole thing, but it basically just outlines what we believe God's part to be. And if I could say it in one word, I'd say it like this. Grace. Grace is God's part. And specifically in the outreach of our ministry, when he says, like he did years ago, Jeremy and Sarah begin taking steps towards a television ministry, okay? That's the command. That's the assignment. But with the assignment, with the command, comes the grace to do it. So grace is His part. And we have got to lean into that grace. Lean on to that grace. Get so dependent on it. Like Paul said, I labored more abundantly than they all, yet not I, but the grace of God that was with me. And we feel like that sometimes. I mean, our schedule has got us going and going and going and going. And if we're not traveling, we're here preaching. And sometimes I feel like we are laboring abundantly. Mm-hmm. But there are times that I sense it's the grace of God on us and in us. But that's His part. So the next part of partnership, after you've got God's part, is our part. If His part's grace, what's our part?
Faith.
Faith. Faith is our part. Faith is to hear the command, hear the instruction. And instead of saying, oh God, TV, how are we ever going to do that? Don't you know how much money we don't have? And we're just this little team and we've only got two or three people. And how are we going to do that? Just this whiny attitude. That is not the appropriate response to grace. The only appropriate response to grace is faith. In other words, if God said do it, then He must believe you can do it. And He's going to equip you to do it. And by God, we're going to do it. We are going to do it no matter what it takes, no matter what it costs, no matter what time we've got to invest in it. Faith is our part. Faith so dependent upon that grace. So those are the first two parts of partnership. But then what's the third part? I told you there was three. There's God's part, there's our part, then there's your part. You have a part to play in partnership. What is your part? Grace is His part. Faith is our part. Your part is to hear the vision. Your part is to tune into this and find out, check on the inside. Does your heart beat like ours does? Are you passionate about the things we're passionate about? You might say, well, I don't know. What is that? Very simply this. We preach Jesus. We believe that an entire generation can be saved and not just saved, but come alive, be so set on fire, not just with principles from the Word, not just with behavior changes in how you live, but with a love for Jesus, with a revelation of who Jesus is. We believe that. I know many people watch this broadcast that are not just of our generation. I know we've got our parents' generation watching, our grandparents' generation watching. I've got great-grandparents still alive on this earth preaching Jesus like they never have before. Many of you know who they are. So we've got several generations watching and beholding this right now. And I would say to you, if you're passionate about your kids, grandkids, great-grandkids, getting a hold of the word of faith, the same thing that turned your life around and set you on the course that you're living today, if you're passionate about that next generation getting it, this is what we're all about. Jesus for every generation. That's what's right at the top of this magazine, every one that goes out. Jesus for every generation. People have asked us before, Sarah, like, what's your demographic? They always want to know, what's your demographic? Who are your case studies here? And that's why I go back to what Paul said after he said here in Colossians 1:28, Him we preach, warning every man, teaching every man, that we may present every man perfect in Christ Jesus. Who was Paul's demographic? Every man. Mm-hmm. If you were to ask him that question, Paul, what's your demographic? Who are you really going after with this message? He'd say, the entire world. I won't be satisfied until everyone everywhere has heard the good news of the gospel. So we've just sort of taken that on as our assignment. Now, of course, everybody, I believe, is assigned to minister to serve their generation.
Yeah.
We're born at this time with a purpose. But we're going after everyone, everywhere, every day.
Yeah.
And that's what the increase in this television ministry is all about, getting aggressive about going from one broadcast a week on one network to having enough content to reach out on some platform somewhere, whether it's television or internet, wherever we can, every day with Jesus.
Yeah,
that's absolutely what this is about. I wanted you to give just people a glimpse of kind of some of the growth that's taken place and what those who are partners, what they've enabled us to do some, and then by the end of this, we'll make invitation for anybody who else wants to get on board.
Well, this year has been the most awesome year for us. I mean, every year has been great, but 2016, we haven't been able to stop thanking the Lord for what he's done, looking mm-hmm. back over the year. We stepped out in faith and launched this television ministry this year, and I would say it was probably one of the harder years. There was grace to do it, but it was, well, I wouldn't say harder. There was grace, but it was more work than we've ever done before.
Plowing some ground.
Yeah, plowing ground. And I think that we got to the point where we finally just realized we couldn't wait any longer to do what God had called us to do. And we didn't need everything. We didn't need all the equipment that it took. They say that you need to start a TV broadcast, mm-hmm. so we didn't need all the staff or the people. We just said, we're going to start this thing, and we're going to obey God. And it was awesome how he helped us, and the grace of God has come on us. But these are the things that happened this year that has been awesome. We're thanking God for. We created a new app, and that app has been downloaded. How many times did you say? 15?
Over 15,000.
Over 15,000. People have downloaded it so far, and we have welcomed 350 new partners around that to the PMI family.
And that was just in last year.
Just this year, we've added 350 new partners, and we've had 1,300 new subscribers to the Legacy Letter just this year. So now the magazine's being sent to over 7,000 people. So that's cool. In 50 states and 74 countries around
the
world.
Thank you, Lord.
And that's an amazing thing to think that it's getting that, reaching that far. We have added more interns and staff, and we've been able to do our outbound prayer team calling, and we're ministering to our partners now through prayer. And it's so cool to hear all your testimonies and to get them in the mail and to hear what God's doing in your life. It is such a joy for Jeremy and I to get those testimonies across our desk and to read them. And I don't know how many times we've just sat there and cried over the testimonies that we get. We hosted our first International Legacy Weekend in Manchester, England, where we got to minister to partners and ministers all over.
My England Cup.
Oh, yeah, he got his England Cup. But that was so cool to be able to meet with people there and ministers and bless them. I think that's a huge part of this ministry, our calling to minister to ministers. And it's been so neat to see our generation coming up and people that are strong in faith and teaching faith to this generation as well. We're not the only ones doing this, and it's really neat to connect to those people. We got to do that this year, and it's been our great honor. We've got to minister in 45 church services in 35 states in the U.S., and then we got to do 10 international services in Canada and England, and it's been an awesome year. God has been good to us, and this year is even greater, is going to be even better.
So 2017 is just ramping up to be, like I said, absolutely monumental. So as you're considering where you are supposed to connect with somebody doing something in the kingdom of God, this is just an open invitation to you. Find out from God if you've got a part in this. It's like I always tell you, you're welcome in this house. You are welcome in this house. Sarah and I are going to be back in just a moment, and we're going to pray with you today before we go. Don't go anywhere.
Fail not, I'll stand with you and not be moved. You cannot lie. I judge you faithful. I know you always follow through. You cannot. Thank you.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I bless the partners of Pearson's Ministries International.
Yes, thank you.
I speak increase over them and their children. I thank you, Lord, that you are opening up doors of favor for them, areas of favor and increase in their lives. And I ask you, Father, to cause them to know that their seed into this ministry is opening up a door of access for you to get involved with their lives, and everything they set their hand to do will prosper in Jesus' name, and I thank you for it. Now, Lord, those who you're dealing with and you're talking to about getting on board with us in this assignment, preaching Jesus as we travel, preaching Jesus in the television broadcast, preaching Jesus through the music ministry of Pearson's Ministries, I'm asking you, Lord, to speak clearly to them and cause them to know exactly what you want them to do. And we welcome them into this family of faith. We welcome them with open arms and open hearts, and we call you blessed in the name of Jesus. We thank God for you. And God, I know, Sarah, that this touches his heart. I know it touches him in a way. I know that because of how it does us and how it does me on the inside. I will never get over somebody being sensitive enough to the Lord that all he had to do is say, I want you involved over here. And they pray for us, or they send us a letter to encourage us, or they put an offering in the mail, or they text an offering in, or website, or whatever they do to get it to us. It just comes over me. I don't use the word overwhelming very much. I don't use it about other things. I endeavor to only use it in reference to the love of God. And this is his love. So Paul said, we heard from Epaphras, who declared to us your love for us in the Spirit. Every time you partner, every time you pray, it's a declaration of the love of God that he's put in you for us. And all we can hope and pray is that you feel it from us too. And our entire staff is in this room, and they can attest to the fact that we are praying for you, believing God for you, calling you healed, whole, and well, and rich in Jesus' name. We do it every day, and we believe those prayers are working. Praise the Lord. We love you so much. We thank God for you. If there's ever anything we can do for you, call us. There's a phone number on your screen right now. Call that number. You're going to have to leave a message because our whole prayer team is also our TV team and everything else, but we're going to get back to you. We're going to pray with you. We're going to encourage you. We love you. Thanks for watching Legacy Television today. And never forget, you're always welcome in the house of faith.